Hey everyone, welcome back to 996. That was the Howl. The Coyotes win 4-3. Huge, huge comeback victory for the Coyotes. A rare one. We rarely see the Coyotes battle back from such a big deficit as 3-0. Very good moving forward, facing adversity, overcoming obstacles. A very emotional game too, with the return of Jacob Chychrun to Arizona. Craig Morgan had a wonderful article about Chychrun returning. He was very emotional. He had some really great words about Arizona. Maybe if you read between the lines, he kind of misses the sun, if anything. Let's get into this game. Ingram starts the game. Durzi is still day-to-day. We are sorely missing Sean Durzi on the back end. Thankfully, someone stepped up and scored on the defensive side of things. And the line changes. Seems like Turney's trying to figure something out with the bottom two lines. This game, we had Zucker, Cooley, and O'Brien on the fourth line. Third line was Carconi, McBain, and Sanford. McBain had a great game. I love that he's back into the lineup. So let's get into it. Thought the Coyotes had a great start to this game. First 5 minutes of the game, each line was rolling, getting chances. Even O'Brien had a good chance early from a feed from Cooley. Cooley had a great game as well, but right after that, the Ottawa Senators get an early goal, 1-0, an odd deflection from a point shot. Seemed a bit undeserved, but we roll on. Right after going down 1-0, Dumba almost had a partial breakaway, almost scored on that one, and then after that scoring chance, he gets into a fight with Tkachuk. He loses that fight pretty decisively. I would even say a bit of an embarrassing fight for Dumba there. Not sure why Dumba decided to drop the gloves. Maybe he wanted to help the team out by himself sitting in the box for 5 minutes. After the fight, Arizona still battling, still getting good offensive chances. They had good sustained offensive pressure as well. They had a power play. They failed at it. Then they go on the penalty kill and the Ottawa Senators score again and make it 2-0. Just a harmless shot from the point. Ingram a bit screened, finds its way in to make it 2-0. And then after that, the Senators make it 3-0 off another deflection. Again, it seemed like Ottawa was scoring off momentum. It wasn't like Ottawa was dominating and getting all these goals. Just felt like a couple bounces went the way of the Senators and they find themselves up 3-0. That was it for Ingram. Near the end of the first period, Vemelka comes in relief for Ingram. Vemelka coming off a shutout against Buffalo. And I thought at this point, I don't think it was Ingram letting the team down. I really don't think Ingram played poorly. I don't think the goals were Ingram's fault. I know I'm an Ingram enjoyer and I love Ingram, but I think this was more of a tone change. Turney didn't like what was happening. The fact that the Coyotes were kind of dominating, but still down 3-0, just wake the guys up, sort of a pseudo timeout, if you will. So Vemelka goes in net, Ingram gets the bench, and then right after the goalie pull, Kraus had a great chance off a deflection. Korpisalo made a huge glove save on Kraus, a late penalty in the first, and the Coyotes kill it. They go in the second period, Coyotes come out flat here, so low energy. The first 10-12 minutes of the second period was not going the way of the Coyotes. Barely entered the offensive zone. They only had one shot in the first 12 minutes. They had a hard time really doing anything, and I thought this was it. The Coyotes were going to give up. Like, come on. It was early in the game. You had a great first period. You outshot the Senators 13-7 in the first. Sure, you're down 3-0, but you got to have some battle instinct in you. You know, it's the Senators. Remember, you know, last year the Coyotes were up 4-0 against the Senators, and then the Senators made it 5-4, and then the Coyotes scored 4 in the third to win 8-5. Like, the Senators-Coyotes games are a bit wild. You got to try a bit more. And then right after the 12-minute mark in the second, the Coyotes get a power play, which they don't score on, but right when it expires, McBain scores from Cooley and Carconi, a weird scoring line. I mean, Carconi, Cooley, and McBain in on the stat for the goal. That's not a real line for the Coyotes, so a bit weird there. But great to see McBain get rewarded, get the team on the board. And then that moment, that power play, even though they didn't score on it, that was like the turning point of the game From that point on, the Coyotes did not look back. It was about 8 minutes left in the second period. And remember when I said the Coyotes had one shot in the first 12 minutes of the second? They ended the second period with 12 shots. So that's 11 shots in the last 8 minutes of the second period. They had all the momentum after the power play. And then right when the second period was ending, Cooley gave a great feed to Dermott, but unfortunately, Dermott was denied there. So we go into third period and you felt it. The crowd was into it. That goal from McBain really gave the team some juice, and they can continue that momentum from the second into the third. This was a wonderful, phenomenal third period by the Coyotes. They had the Senators on their heels. The Senators didn't even barely enter the Coyotes zone. Whenever the Senators had possession of the puck, they were throwing it down the ice or dumping it and then getting a line change because they were defending way too much. Early in the third, McBain got involved in a scrum. We really missed McBain in the bottom six of this team. He just adds talent, adds some physicality. He's just a good player to have in your bottom six, and you really notice his impact missing when he's not in the lineup, and he just makes players good around him as well, and he could fit on a lot of different lines, so I really like having McBain back in the lineup. And he doesn't look like he came from a 15-16 game injury. I really, really like how the Coyotes put him back in the lineup when he was fully healthy and he's 100% and having his normal impact on the game. So after that scrum, Moser scores off a rebound from Michelli. Valimaki also gets an assist there. You could feel it coming. They made it 3-2, and just the crowd was so electric, and you felt it. You were just waiting for these goals to happen. And right after that Moser goal, Keller scores from Stetcher, and Kerfoot, a nice spinorama goal there. Really nice from Keller to score right after that 3-2 goal to tie 3-3. The team was loving it, and they just continue. The first 10 minutes of this third period was all Coyotes, and it continued after those 10 minutes. And the game-winning goal comes from Kesselring, assisted by Sanford and McBain. So great two-point game from McBain. Vemelka gets the shutout. He gets the credit for the win. So that's back-to-back shutouts for Vemelka. About 130 minutes of shutout time he's playing with right now. The Coyotes have San Jose next, I believe, on Thursday. A wonderful comeback in an emotional game with Jacob Chychrun coming back. Coyotes were 0 for 2 on the power play, but even though they didn't score on that second power play, I already said that second power play really got it going. Just getting some confidence in the offensive zone, because they went 12 minutes with barely entering the Ottawa's defensive zone in that second period, and that just kicked things off. Penalty kill, 1 for 2. Faceoffs are 54%. Remember what I say in those progress reports. Whenever the Coyotes are over 50%, it's like a 90% chance they're winning the game. And the shots, 38-22 for Arizona. I love that. I love it when the Coyotes shoot over 30 shots. More shots, you're most likely to win. But I understand the game plan of Andre Tourney of it's all about quality over quantity. But I thought a lot of these 38 shots were high quality. In the second period, maybe the Senators were keeping the Coyotes to the outside, but as the game went on, the Coyotes were able to penetrate and get some good high danger chances. And nothing but good things to say about this game. You know, even if they lost this game, even in the first period when they were down 3-0, just felt it was undeserved, and the goals were a bit lucky, and the Coyotes just stuck with it. And it's a great win for the standings, a great 2 points. If they lost in overtime, I would have been happy with that as well. Just the fact that they battled back down a big hole really shows this team cares and wants to win. Like I said, they got San Jose Thursday. Should be a winnable game, but, you know, you can't, you know, take your guard off the Sharks. If they win that game and they go like, and they're 17-13-2 after that, pretty good record. And, you know, moving into the new year, they just got to sustain, get some points here and there, and they just ride this out. It could be a wonderful time in 2024. So that's it for me. Thank you for watching. If you like what you see, spread the word. And as always, thank you for your support.